students, glad to speak with you all through this video. This is third class of chapter 6, electromagnetic induction. In this chapter, totally 8 marks or 7 marks will be asked for your board exam. In this chapter, no topics were related. Okay, so in this chapter we have to study all the topics. Clear? So before going to start this topic, let me recall the previous one. In previous topics, we start this chapter, we studied magnetic flux. That is our first topic. 5b, number of magnetic field lines passing perpendicular to the area vector. Okay, so what is the formula? 5b equal to ba cos theta. This is a scalar quantity and its unit is Weber. So unit of magnetic flux is Weber, right? Then we saw about Faraday's experiment, right? So what is first Faraday's law? Whenever the magnetic flux linked with the closed coil changes, an EMF induced. That is first law. So for that we study some examples like magnet moving through the coil. So when the magnetic field lines link with the area of the coil, we get a magnetic flux and some current is induced in that coil. Okay, so whenever there is relative motion between a coil and magnetic field lines, an EMF induced in the coil, right? Then we studied about Faraday's second law. What is second law? The magnitude of induced EMF is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux, phi equal to d phi by dt. To find the direction of induced EMF, we use Lenz's law. What is Lenz's law? The direction of induced EMF is always opposes the cause responsible for its production. So here the cause means either magnetic field increase or magnetic field decrease, either area increase or area decrease, that is the cause. Okay, we use the term kid kills father, right? So for that we saw so many examples to find the direction of induced EMF in coil. And then we studied one important example, that is magnetic coil example. So we use the term, if you come, I won't let you come. If you go, I won't let you go. Okay, that is the best example. That is the best way to remember the topic. If north pole moving towards the coil, then the upper half of the coil behave as north pole. If north pole moving away from the coil, then upper half of the coil behave as south pole. Okay, if you come, I won't let you come. Okay, the pole will starts to repel by creating the same pole which is coming towards it. If you go, I won't let you go means the pole will behave as opposite pole which is moving away from the coil, right? Then we studied that Lenz's law is applicable for is obeys law of conservation of energy. Of course, all the laws which are in physics should obey law of conservation of energy, and this Lenz's law also obey the law of conservation of energy. Okay, so in this topic we are going to solve some numericals based on rotating coils. So how induced EMF creating in rotating coils? The first problem, we have to find the average induced EMF in the coil if it rotates 60 degree in 2 seconds. So this is our circular coil. Okay, we rotate it in clockwise direction about 60 degree. So we rotate it, the circuit coil, about 60 degree. Okay, so we have to find the EMF, average induced EMF. The given datas are theta is given and time t equal to 2 seconds, which is also given. Okay, so by using this formula, we know the formula of induced EMF. I consider only magnitude here. So average induced EMF, for average I use the del symbol. Okay, so del phi divided by del t. So why we use negative sign in the formula? Because in Lenz's law it is stated that the induced EMF always oppose the cause responsible for its production. Okay, so to denote the term oppose, we use the negative symbol. Okay, So it doesn't matter, here we only consider magnitude only. So EMF equal to del phi by del t. So we already studied how to find the average. So average means final minus initial, right? Average kinetic energy means kinetic energy due to final velocity minus kinetic energy due to initial velocity, right? That is average. So here, instead of del phi, I can write phi of final minus phi of initial divided by del t, right? So final flux minus initial flux. What is initial flux here? Just take phi I. What is initial flux? This is our area, okay? So area is always perpendicular to our eyesight. So area coming like this, okay, towards our eyesight. Then we have dot magnetic field. So dot magnetic field also coming towards outside, coming towards our eyesight. So both are in same direction, right? Can you feel it? Both are in same direction. If both are in same direction, then we get zero, right? The angle is zero. Angle between magnetic field and the area is zero, right? So we can write BA cos 0 degree. Further, we can write BA, okay? So phi I equal to, what is A? Area of the circle. The radius is given as R. So we can write the area of the circle as B pi R square. Clear? So this is initial flux. Then what we did? The coil rotates 60 degree in 2 seconds. So it rotates 60 degree like that. Okay, it rotates 60 degree. Okay. So final flux will be phi F B A cos 60 degree. So cos 60 will be 1 by 2 b, instead of a I write pi r square, area of the coil, cos 60 is 1 by 2. So we can write b pi r square divided by 2. Substitute all this value in this equation. So we get phi f, we only consider magnitude, phi f b pi r square divided by 2 minus b pi r square, okay, divided by del t. So here time is given as 2 seconds, okay? So here we have half b pi r square, here we have 1 b pi r square. So half minus 1, we get minus half, right? Half b pi r square minus 1 b pi r square. Half minus 1 minus half, right? So we only consider magnitude. So I can take plus half b pi r square divided by 2. Clear? Then we get my final answer will become b pi r square divided by 4. Right? Here, what is the direction of induced EMF in this coil? Initially, we have B pi R square. Then, finally, we have B pi R square by 2, which means our flux value reduce, right? So, initially, I have one flux and finally, I have half B pi R square. Okay, my flux value reduced to half. So, in order to increase it, I have to add a magnetic field. Okay, I have to add magnetic field. Magnetic field is already coming outwards. I have to add more magnetic field in order to increase the magnetic field, because by using Lenz's law, we have to oppose it. Okay, so to oppose it, I have to take like this. To add some magnetic field in outwards, and my 4 curl finger shows anti-clockwise direction. So the direction of current is anti-clockwise. Okay, can you able to find the value of current by using this value? Why not take resistance of this coil as small r? Okay, resistance of this coil is small r. Now you find the value of current. Here we have EMF value, here we have resistance value. So find the value of current and post it in group. Okay, so move to the next problem. In this problem, the value of B, magnetic field is 4 into 10 power minus 2 Tesla, and omega, angular velocity, 300 revolution per minute. Okay, per minute it is rotated 300 revolutions. And area of the coil, rectangular coil, is given 25 centimeter square, and resistance given 4 ohm. Okay, resistance of this rectangular coil. We have to find the induced EMF in half turn and full turn, charge flow in the coil in half turn. For example, this is our rectangular coil. Okay, so initially it is like this, and the half turn means it rotate. Okay, so this is half turn. Full turn means again it rotate. So this is one complete turn. It starts from here and end here, that is one complete turn. Okay, so initially the coil is like this. Half turn means it rotate like this. Okay, 180 degree. Then full turn means it's again rotate 180 plus 180, 360 degree. Clear? Actually change this question. We have to find average induced EMF. Okay, average induced EMF. So what is the formula? I take the first one, half turn. For half turn, we have to find the induced EMF. Okay, for half turn, the formula is EMF equal to, here it is given half average, so del phi divided by del t. Okay, so I can write phi f minus phi I divided by del t, right, for half turn. So what is phi I here? So initially my circular coil like this. Okay, magnetic field coming towards our eyesight, and this area also coming towards our eyesight, both are in same direction. So for initial condition, I take phi f as b a cos 0, right? So our initial condition, phi I equal to b a cos 0. What is final condition? Phi f equal to, this circular coil rotates about half turn. That is my question. So it rotates about half turn. So at here it complete 90 degree, and again here it complete 90 plus 90, 180 degree, because half turn. So for half turn I take BA cos 180. Okay, substitute this value here. Here we get EMF equal to phi f is BA cos 180. What is the value of cos 180? Cos 180 is minus 1. Okay, the value of cos 180 is minus 1. So we get minus BA, right? Then phi I, initial flux, cos 0. Cos 0 value is 1. So we get BA divided by del t. Okay, so minus BA, minus BA, we get minus 2BA. Here we only consider magnitude. So I can take plus 2BA divided by del t. Right? So substitute the value 2 into, the value of B is given 4 into 10 power minus 2 Tesla. Then what is the value of A? A is 25 centimeter square. If it is 25 centimeter, then we add 25 into 10 power minus 2. Then centimeter square. So 25 into 10 power minus 2 into 10 power minus 2. So 10 power minus 2 into 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 4. Okay, because it is given centimeter square. So we have to convert it into meter square. If it is meter, we add 10 to the power minus 2. Then again meter, 10 to the power minus 2. 10 to the power minus 2, 10 to the minus 2, 10 to the power minus 4. So we get 25 into 10 power minus 4. That is our area, divided by time. So here it is given, for 300 revolution it takes 1 minute. Okay, so I can write it here, for 300 revolution it takes 60 seconds. Right? Because we know time is, the SI unit of time is second. So we have to find it for per second. We have to find the revolution for per second. So for 300 revolution, it takes 60 seconds. Then for one revolution, one complete revolution, it takes 60 by 300 second. Okay, so 60 by 300 comes up to 1 by 5 second, right, for one revolution. Here our first condition is for half time. So for half revolution, 1 by 2, so this value also become 1 by 5 into 2 for half revolution. So I get 1 by 10 second. Clear? For one complete revolution, it takes 1 by 5 second. For half revolution, it takes 1 by 10 second. Clear? So this time, for half revolution, I take 1 by 10 second. So 1 by 10 second. Find out this value. The value is in volts. Okay, find out this value. So this is for first condition, half time. The next one is for full time. Full time. Yeah, what is the value for full time? So this is initial position, okay, initial flux. And it rotate half time. Again, it rotate full time. Okay, so for the same formula, I take phi I equal to BA cos 0. Okay, wow. Then phi F I take BA cos 360. Okay, for one complete revolution. Cos 0, what is the value of cos 0? Cos 0 value is 1. Okay, so I take BA. What is the value of cos 360? Cos 360 also equal to 1. So here I get BA. Here we use the formula phi F minus phi I. Okay, so phi F is BA minus phi I also BA. So BA minus BA. The difference between these two flux will be equal to 0 because both have same magnitude. Okay, so phi F minus phi I value will become equal to 0. So my EMF value is also equal to 0. Clear? So for one complete revolution, I get 0 EMF. Okay, then third condition, charge flow in the coil in half time. We have to find the value of charge. How to find charge from this equation? We have the formula for charge I equal to Q by T. Right, current equal to flow of charge per unit time. From that formula, we can take Q equal to I into T. Right, Q equal to I into T. But we don't have I here. So how to find charge? By using these relations, I take I average for third condition. Okay, we have to find charge in half time. So I take I average equal to EMF average divided by R, correct? By using Ohm's law, I equal to V by R. Here V is nothing but EMF, so EMF by R, I equal to V by R. Clear? So what is EMF here? EMF is nothing but change in flux with respect to time, that is EMF, right? Change in flux with respect to time. Okay, so this is EMF and here we have resistance, so 1 by R. Clear? Then we know the another formula for current, that is I average equal to charge average divided by time average, I equal to Q by T, flow of charge with respect to time. Clear? So I have two equations for I average. So my left hand side of the equations are same. So hence my right hand side also will be equal to same. So if I compare these two equations, then I get del Q by del T equal to del phi by del t into 1 by r. Clear? I compare the right hand side of the equation. So del t get cancelled. Then I have del q equal to del 5 into 1 by r. What is our del phi value here? Del phi is nothing but average flux. So phi final minus phi initial divided by r. So you find the value. We already found the phi final for half term, phi initial for half term divided by resistance. Resistance is given as 4 ohm in the problem. So substitute all the value, then you get del q, okay, average charge flow through the circuit. What is the unit of charge? Coulomb. Okay, substitute all the value, then find the value, find the answer. Third problem, find induced EMF in the coil at time t equal to, sorry, at time t. Also plot graph for I versus t. This coil have some fixed end at the center. Okay, so this coil placed just adjacent with the magnetic field, cross magnetic field. Okay, so it fixed end and it starts to rotate with this fixed end at an angular velocity omega. Okay, so it starts to rotate like this. It starts to rotate. Clear? So in this problem, take omega angular velocity equal to angular displacement with respect to time. Right? That is the form of velocity. Velocity equal to displacement by time. So here displacement is taken as angular displacement because it starts to rotate. So angular velocity equal to angular displacement with respect to time. So what is the symbol for angular displacement? Theta divided by time. Okay. So from this formula I can take theta equal to omega t. Here the coil starts to rotate like this. Okay, so the coil rotate like this. Okay, this is initial position. After t time, after t equal to t, we rotate the coil at an angle theta. So this is how the coil rotate at time t equal to t. This is fixed end. Now I rotate the coil. Okay, so some part of the coil have link with magnetic field, right? Some part of the coil, the area of the coil links with magnetic field lines. So we get magnetic flux. Now what is the formula for magnetic flux? Phi equal to BA cos theta. What is theta here? Magnetic field lines going inwards, okay, like this, going inwards. Then area also going inwards, okay. If I see the area from behind this coil, then it also going inwards. So this small part, the area of this small part also going inwards. Magnetic field lines also going inwards. So the angle will be zero, okay. So we get phi equal to BA. So what is A? Area of this small part, okay, area of this small part. How to find this area? As we know, if we have a triangle with an arc, okay, then the area taken as, if this is theta and the radius is r, radius is taken as r, then the area taken as theta into r, which means base into height, right? So theta into r. So this arc is theta and this length is r. So area of triangle, base into height, right? Half base into height. Okay, so the area will be half base is theta r, height is r. So this is the area of triangle. So substitute the value in this equation, we get B instead of A, half theta r into r. So half theta r square. Okay, we get phi equal to b r square theta divided by 2. Right, instead of theta substitute this value, phi equal to b r square omega t divided by 2. So at time t, we get this amount of flux at time t, t equal to t. Then what will be induced EMF? EMF equal to, for at instant time, for at instant we use d phi, not del phi. Del phi is for average, for instant. Instant means at particular time. So at particular time t, we take d phi by dt. Okay, so I have to differentiate this whole term with respect to t. So differentiation of this phi with respect to t, then I get b r square omega differentiation of t is 1. Okay, so into 1 divided by 2. So my final value EMF equal to b r square omega divided by 2. Okay, this is my EMF value. So it is asked, we have to plot a graph for I vs t. So find the I value from this equation. I equal to voltage divided by resistance. The resistance is taken as small r, resistance of this semicircular coil. So I can write b r square omega divided by 2r. Okay, so I get I value and I take t value also. So with this two value, we can't able to draw the graph. So we will see more, we have to find more value. So here the magnitude won't change, but the time will change. Okay, the time will change frequently. So the direction of induced EMF in this coil also change. So initially what will happen? This is my initial condition. Okay, there will be no induced EMF. Then after rotating it, my coil area links with the magnetic field lines. So I get phi. Then when my value of phi will increase. Why? Initially I rotate the coil. So sum of the area of the coil linked with the magnetic field lines by using this formula phi equal to BA. So I get B into A contact, I get magnetic flux, and my magnetic flux values increase initially. Then what is the direction of induced EMF in this coil? Because my magnetic field lines change, increase, and the direction of induced EMF should be in opposite direction. Okay, so I have to reduce the magnetic field lines. Initially I have magnetic field lines inwards. To reduce, I have to show outwards. So thumb finger pointing outwards, then my four curl finger shows the direction of induced EMF. Okay, so initially it is in anti-clockwise direction in this coil. Clear? Then after t time, it starts to rotate again. So after t time, it rotate like this. Can you visualize? Okay, initially straight, and after t time it rotates, it starts to rotate, and after t time again it starts to rotate. Then what will happen? Again the magnetic field lines will increase, right? Here small area contact. Okay, here large area, nearly large area contact. So my magnetic flux will also increase. Area of the coil increase, then magnetic flux also increase. So magnetic flux increase, then I have to reduce the magnetic flux to find the direction of induced EMF. So to reduce, I have to show my thumb finger in outwards. Then my direction is also in anti-clockwise direction. So here also I get anti-clockwise direction. Okay, then after t time, what will happen? So after t time, again it starts to rotate. Okay, so large area come inside the magnetic field. Again I have to reduce the magnetic field lines, so the direction will be still anti-clockwise direction, right? Then again it starts to rotate this. Okay, rotate this coil, just visualize. If I rotate this coil, then full coil, full area of the coil comes in contact with the magnetic field lines, right? Comes in contact with the magnetic field lines. So I rotate this in clockwise direction. I rotate the coil in clockwise direction. So whole area comes into the magnetic field lines. Then my magnetic flux also increase. So to reduce the magnetic field lines, my thumb finger pointing outwards. So curl finger shows the direction of induced EMF, again in anti-clockwise direction. If I rotate this again, then what will happen? Just imagine, if I rotate this again in clockwise direction. Okay, again I rotate. So if I again rotate, then I have somewhat like this. Now my sum of the area coming out to the magnetic field lines. Okay, some area coming out. So initially it's somewhat like this. Okay, it's somewhat like this. Then again I rotate. So my small area coming outwards, small area inside the magnetic field lines. So here my magnetic flux decrease. Initially I have full magnetic flux. Then some area coming outwards. So magnetic flux value will decrease, right? So I have to, using Lenz law, I have to increase it. So increase it means already I have cross magnetic field. I have to add some more magnetic field in downwards. So my thumb finger going downwards, then curl finger shows the direction of induced EMF. So curl finger is in clockwise direction. So in this coil, current flows in clockwise direction. Okay, here anti-clockwise. Okay, here clockwise. Clear? So then again what will happen? So I have this type of condition, only half of the area link with the magnetic field lines. So magnetic flux also decrease. So I have to increase the magnetic flux. So again I have clockwise direction. Okay. If you see here, for every half rotation, the direction of induced EMF will change. Okay, initially it is anti-clockwise. Then after half rotation, it will become clockwise direction. Clear? So anti-clockwise, anti-clockwise, anti-clockwise. Half rotation completed. The next half rotation, it will become clockwise, clockwise. Then again we have condition somewhat like this. Right? So the direction will be clockwise. But the magnitude will be same. Direction will change for every half rotation, but magnitude of the current will be same. The same value. Okay? So we can draw a graph for current versus time. Okay, I take current in y-axis, time in x-axis. So initially for every half rotation, one full rotation, I take my time is t. One full rotation, my capital T is, sorry, my small t, time is capital T. So half rotation, my time will be t by 2, right? Then 1.5 rotation, time will be 3t by 2. For one full rotation, my time will be 2t. Okay, so for half rotation, for up to t by 2, my value of I is positive. Okay, and constant, positive and constant. Clear? For another half rotation, from t by 2 to t, from t by 2 to t, this is first condition, second condition, third and fourth. For another half rotation, the time will be t. So for this time, I have negative value, same magnitude. Okay, negative direction, same magnitude. Clear? So here I have b r square omega by 2r. Here I have minus b r square omega by 2r. Okay, so then again, another half rotation for up to 3t by 2, it will change again, but constant, right? And then another half rotation up to 2t, it will change, constant. Clear? So for every half rotation, direction will change, but magnitude wise, the current is same. Clear? Next problem, which is given in your NCERT book, exercise 6.3. A solenoid with 15 turns per centimeter has a small loop area 2 cm square placed inside the solenoid. Normal to its axis. We have a solenoid. I draw it here. Okay, solenoid means, so number of turns wound, okay, in a shape of helix, that is solenoid. So this is our solenoid. Inside the solenoid, okay, inside the solenoid, a small loop area 2 cm square. So inside this, I have a small loop of 2 cm square. normal to its axis. So normal to the axis means, so if this is solenoid, okay, if this is solenoid, then this is my loop area. So here I have a small loop. Okay, so normal to its axis, it creates an angle of 90 degrees. So this is my area vector. Okay, here I have solenoid of this small loop. Here I have small loop. Okay, if the current carried by the solenoid changes steadily from 2 ampere to 4 ampere in 1 second. So the current carried by the solenoid changes from 2 ampere to 4 ampere in 0.1 second. Find EMF when current changing. We have to find the EMF of this small loop. Okay, write the given data as we have 15 turns per centimeter. Okay, so turns per centimeter. Usually here we have number of turns per meter. So I have to convert centimeter into meter, right? So for per centimeter I have 15 turns. So per meter I have 15 into 100, right? So 15 into 100 means 1500 turns per meter. Okay, 15 into 100. Then area of loop given, the small area, okay, given 2 cm². So I can take area equal to 2 × 10⁻⁴ m² Okay. So what is the magnetic field produced by the solenoid? We know the formula. Magnetic field due to the solenoid, which we studied in previous chapter, B equal to mu naught n I, right? Here n means number of turns per unit length, capital N divided by L, number of turns per unit length. Okay, so what is the formula for magnetic flux? Phi equal to B dot A. So we have to find EMF, then EMF equal to d phi by dt. Okay, so what is d phi? dBA by dt. Here actually theta is 0 degree. If you see here, theta is 0 degree. Why? Area also pointing this direction. This is area vector. Okay, so magnetic field due to solenoid and its axis will be like this. Okay, magnetic field also in the same direction. So both are in same direction and the angle will be 0. Okay, here what is variable? So here area is constant. I can write this equation, EMF equal to dA or A into dB by dt. Okay, I rewrite this equation, A into dB by dt. Magnetic field change with respect to time. Why? Because current change with respect to time. So magnetic field is directly proportional to current. When current change with respect to time, then definitely magnetic field also change with respect to time, right? So I write this change in magnetic field with respect to time. Okay, so now what is the value of magnetic field of solenoid mu naught n I? Here I is changing current, not a steady current. Okay, I is not a constant current, but it changes steadily from 2 ampere to 4 ampere. Okay, so I can write A, instead of dB, I write mu naught n dI by dt. Okay, so instead of dB, change in magnetic flux is because of change in current. Okay, so this change in magnetic flux because of this change in current with respect to time, which is given in the problem. So it changed from 2 ampere to 4 ampere in 1 second, 0.1 second. Clear? So substitute all the value. Our A is 2 × 10⁻⁴. Then mu naught 4 π × 10⁻⁷. Then number of turns per unit length is 1500. Okay. Change in current So change in current means final current minus initial current. So final current is 4 ampere, initial current is 2 ampere, and time is 0.1 second. Okay, so if you substitute and solve all this, we get EMF value. So find that value yourself. Okay, don't use calculator, don't use mobile calculator. Try it yourself and try to find the answer. When you solve more numericals like this, then it will be easy for you to solve very quickly in your exam. Okay, so solve this and find the answer, post it in group.